Do you have any idea who your mother was before she was your mother? Not a chance. I know for sure my daughters had no idea who I was until it was too late. My grandmother once told me that my life wasn't going to be about finding myself. It would be about creating myself. And the day my father refused to let me follow my passions to art school was the day I knew I'd have to listen to my Nan. My name is Katherine Hudson, and my story begins in 1965. Remember the 1960s? The swinging 60s? If you're too young, then let me enlighten you. Wow, what a decade. It was the decade when everything changed, everything. It was about drugs and sex and rock and roll. It was about flower power, mop tops, and groovy experiences, man. It was also about the big downers, the war in Vietnam, and race riots. It was about women's liberation and out-of-sight fashion. Fashion? Yes. The 60s started with Wilhelmina and gloves and hats, and ended with miniskirts and knee socks and Twiggy. And that's where I wanted my life to go. I wanted to create the most beautiful clothes in the world. I wanted my designs splashed across the pages of fashion magazines. Well, this small town girl's life really began the minute she walked into that smoke-filled coffee house in Toronto. And there on the stage was Joni Mitchell. That was when I knew I'd have to find a way to get to New York. The Big Apple, the center of the universe, the greatest city in the world. And I did. But something changed in me when I met someone at Woodstock, not just anyone. And she told me that my life would only ever be as much as I was willing to settle for. So I made plans. But here was another thing my grandmother told me. If you want to make God laugh, tell her your plans. I think I'll be getting some kind of award for making God laugh so much. Come along with me on my journey. Together, we can learn that designing the life you want might be harder than you think.